Ven needs a safe place.
Hey there, people. My name is Tori, and welcome back to more Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. This episode is going to be a lot of cutscene.
All right. If that's where you want,
I guess
to
we'll
go.
Mostly just see where it takes us. For now, Aqua is taking Ven somewhere safe, somewhere where he can sleep, until his heart is fixed. There are a few parts to a person, according to Kingdom Hearts. There is the body, which honestly is what Aqua is carrying right now. Ugh. The destroyed castle. Ven's body feels like he needs to go here for some reason. So there's the body, there's the heart. Hearts can become nobodies, or hearts can become heartless, and bodies can become nobodies. It's very confusing, but whatever.
Of course, I would never let that happen. I promise you I will bring Terra back. Only this time, you'll see he has what it takes to be a master.
So in a way, I feel like
he's not as weak as you think.
Aqua feels like she let all of them down. She promised Ericus that she would bring Terra home, and then she also promised Terra himself that she would watch over him.
Now
not that,
that
he wanted
a master,
it.
There is one secret in particular you must know. Should anything happen to me and you find the Legion of Darkness at our doorstep, I ask that you take my Keyblade and use it to lock this land away.
What?
Generations of Keyblade Masters have been charged with keeping this land safe. Light and darkness exist in balance here, and there are those who would abuse such neutral ground. This is why our predecessors devised a certain trick. Just use the key, and this land will be transformed. That day forward, all who visit this land will be lost to oblivion, none ever able to solve the mystery. None, Aqua, except you.
So Ven will be safe here.
I know it's a lonely place, but you'll be safe. Terra and I will be back to wake you up before you know it.
This is a place that no one will be able to get to, but if it so happens that he wakes up, I wonder if he'd be able to get out. As she's marching out, the entire world has changed sealed away, and it's become a castle that will lead others into oblivion.
Put an end to me.
Tara, tell me where to find you.
So even now, I feel like this is neutral ground. And then we get Brightcrest. In the last episode, we did get 3 new Keyblades, so I wonder how this one stacks up. Let's take a look at it real quick. We can open the menu in this area, and let's see what Brightcrest does. 4 and 7. Long Reach provides an outstanding boost in magic, which is no greater than Royal Radiance, and let's see. It's slightly better than Ultima Weapon. It also makes it easier to land critical hits and deal higher damage when you do. So, if you want to land critical hits, and for some reason focus on them, this would probably be the Keyblade to use. I think. If you have not finished those arena boss fights, you can do those here. As you can see, the Land of Departure is gone, as is the path leading to the Keyblade Graveyard, and when you run into it, you just bounce off. So, let's go to Radiant Garden. So she has not seen Tara since the fight in the Keyblade Graveyard began. She doesn't know that Xehanort has taken over.
Am I?
And the fusion terrible did not go well, darkness. Clearly.
Fight it! Tara, please!
Tara, you say?
The body.
Tara's heart has been extinguished.
Tara's body is rebelling against Xehanort. Or I guess as it's known now, Terranort?
My name is Master Aqua. Now return my friend's heart.
This clown of a Keyblade. Very tense moment, which is absolutely spoiled by my choice of Keyblade. However, it's a good Keyblade, I tell you what. So, let's fight Terranort. And all my shit's on cooldown. Fun! Okay. Ow. Do it. Ow.
Take
I need to change that. Ouch. Would it be bad form to D-Link? Reflecting those bullets is where a lot of damage is going to be coming from. Okay, got out of that. Can I D-Link? I can. Ironically, I can D-Link with Terra. So I don't think I ever mentioned the ice cream, something that I said that I would mention and explain and show, which I clearly am not. The ice cream is used to go into specific command styles whenever you want. Consuming one will put you in that command style. Consuming another one while you're in that command style will just fill up the gauge immediately. Ow. Ah, meteor. Fuck. Ow. Ah. He can heal. Now going into a style.
Sink into darkness.
Ah, that can't be blocked! Like it can in, say, another game. So, apparently all of my abilities, all of my commands, are just completely worthless. Ow. Let's see Thunder Surge. Because I'm pretty sure, at this point, this is the only one that I have not done. Okay, Thunder Surge actually does a lot. Trying to block that. What I do find really fun is that most of these attacks are things that Terra can actually get. And in the case of Quake and Meteor, only he can get them. That's Arsolem. I was about to be deaf. Ow. This is a lot of pain. Uh-huh. Where is Thunder Surge?
You have lost!
Ow! There we go. Yet. Hey, I have lost. In all, this isn't a very difficult fight. You just have to stay on top of your health. He doesn't do that thing that most bosses in this game do, which is drop your health to 1 in one hit. Oh wait, there's a part 2, I forgot about that. And this is the first time that we get to see his dark shadow. Done? No? Oh, come on. He's just zigzagging. Ah, owie. Once again, not all that dangerous. He didn't drop my health too much. That's just hilarious. Ooh-hoo-hoo. I dodged through that correctly. And I do want to stay close to him. So that on the last one here, I can just push him. Hey. Honestly, that doesn't do a lot of damage. So probably not worth it. But it's fun nonetheless. I probably should have stacked my deck a little bit better. And Ghost Charge. Ghost Drive. That actually really worked out! When I hit him with the Barrier Surge, I figured that I would go into Ghost Drive. And I just figured, hey, how would this do?
Stop fighting back!
Terra, I know you're in there.
This'll teach you. Get out of my heart.
At least that felt... It seemed like a soft landing. How he got so far is a mystery. She can kick her Keyblade into overdrive.
to do something, or we'll both be lost. I'm with you. Go!
I don't know how that helped.
Ben, I'm sorry. I might not make it back as soon as I thought. But I promise I'll be there one day to wake you up.
Hey, I'm gonna head back.
Yeah, me too.
Sora, what's wrong?
Huh?
You're...
That's weird. It's like... something's squeezing me inside.
Somebody up there must be sad.
Up where?
They say every world is connected by one great big sky. So maybe there's somebody up there in all those worlds who's really hurting. And they're waiting for you to help them.
Well, gee, do you think there's something I could do?
Maybe they just need you to open your heart and listen.
I don't know, Riku. You say some weird stuff sometimes, but I'll try it.
Okay.
How do I do that, though?
Hey, can you hear me?
Right this way.
Young man, what ails you? Can you speak? Tell me your name.
Xehanort.
Xehanort. Huh? Quickly, get him to the castle.
You can count on me. Dylan, get those for me.
Bragg understands what it means when he says Xehanort. He understands the implications.
Seems like I've been walking for ages. How long have I been down here? Maybe I should fade into the darkness here.
There were four of those, right? Because that holds some very interesting implications for the series.
I guess it's been so long. I almost forgot how to smile.
How long has she been down here? A few hours, a few days. Aqua is really one of my favorite characters because she just wants to do the right thing to help everyone. And she just gets dragged into all of this unfortunate circumstances. And yet she still moves forward. She does her best.
There's to always a way.
All right. So, and I'm going to turn this down in editing, right, me? Yeah, there we go. Better. So, this is where the game would normally end. However, there is another chapter. It was only added in the final mix version. So, it's interesting. I will say that it's not something I've actually played. Before starting this, I hadn't even unlocked it. I've watched videos on what it is, and it's pretty straightforward. So I may make it into its own video, or I may add it on to the end of this one, just kind of depending on its length. We'll see. And that, I promise, is where the actual end is. Then we can move on. But I'll try to share some of my thoughts on this game. I do enjoy it in some capacity. It's not a perfect game. There's a lot of flaws in it. However, the story is incredible, especially with what it means for Kingdom Hearts as a whole, the series. It sets up a lot of very important points, very important concepts, and it is important to understand where these characters come from and what they're fighting for. It's to see it from three different perspectives all at once is new and refreshing. You understand each of their thought processes, understand what they're going through, and you start your perspective changes depending on which path, which character you're controlling. Terra Xehanort. As far as like the boss battles, that's where it really falls off. None of them are all that good. But that may have just been the limitations of this being on a portable console. You know, a handheld device, especially one that was released, what would that have been? 2006? 5-ish? It certainly didn't have the most power, and they did make a very good and full game with the power that they had. A lot of the worlds were repeated. There were paths that were just cut off for specific characters. But again, that's... they were very creative with what they had. With what they could use. And... the game is... it feels incredibly long. Which... is not necessarily a good thing. If you want to play one story, good. It's easy to go through and play it once with that character. But if you want to play the entire game and get the full story, playing all three of them can feel draining. And that is why I hesitate to play this game a lot. It's what kept me from truly finishing it. It just... dragged on, and I really dreaded it every time that I thought about playing it. I wanted to pick it up, and it just stuck in my mind that I will have to play all three of them. And the biggest reason why that's painful is because you have to start over and build each character up individually. There's no way that you can build them up as one. All these save files are separate. So your abilities that you unlock from melding, you have to unlock them each for each character. And that's what hurts, especially because it doesn't tell you which ability you're going to get. You have to look that up. It'll tell you what you will get as far as like the command is concerned, but it doesn't tell you what ability. There are a lot of abilities that I just left out because I would have to go out of my way to get them. There should be an easier way. Maybe if you could, I don't know, use those, ability gems. Just by cracking the ability itself, I don't know. It needs refining. And I don't know if there's a good way to do that, given how it is set up. The commands themselves are fun. A lot of them are very fun. The power scaling is... I would say it's a very well-paced scale. You don't get very powerful abilities unless you are towards the end of the game or you have kept on top of melding other commands that you just find. And you can certainly get things like Fyraga real early on in the game if you just buy, I want to say, 3 fires and max those out immediately. Now, that's not going to carry you through the game, but you can do it. and they are good commands, even to the end. Triple Firiga. So I guess if you buy, what is that? Six? I guess. And you get triple Firiga. That could be pretty effective. But that's just one ability. And then there's just like no reason that your movement commands should be tied to an ability, like in a deck like that. I guess it's only concerned about melding. But point being, there are a bunch of movement abilities that I didn't get. So there's like dash, and then there's fire dash, I think. And those are pretty useless because they remove a lot of the iframes that really are mandatory for this game. If you're not fighting super bosses, then you could probably use them. But endgame, all you're going to want to fight is super bosses. So it's just very confusing to me. Because it is a good game, as far as the story is concerned. But it's... there's a lot that needs to be worked on. This is a lot of people's favorite Kingdom Hearts game. I think it becomes easier when you differentiate, like, non-mainline game. The mainline being Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and 3. Everything else is just a side game. And it did become more accessible with these HD collections. But I don't know. It just is so rough. In some respects, I would actually put Chain of Memories above this one, which is very controversial, I know. But it's honestly how I feel. Maybe it's a nostalgia factor, and I am a very nostalgic person. I've gotten a ton of good memories of playing Chain of Memories, especially base Chain of Memories, original Chain of Memories on the Game Boy Advance, as a child, as a kid, which I guess it came out in 2004. I was 12. I remember having to wait to get that game. And I do remember playing this one. I remember playing it when it first came out. I got it as fast as I could. I was still like 14, 15, so it's not like I had... also, I lived in a very remote town, so to get it, I would need to go, an hour out of my way to go get it, and I couldn't drive. So... It was hard for me to get immediately. It's not a terrible game, it's just very rough. And I think the ability system is holding it back. So, we see here Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, and it'll tell us here, right? Oh, what's this? What's with the mask, the in the top left.
Hey, can you hear me?
I heard your voice. It cut through the darkness around me. Huh. All alone, I followed the sound into a sea of light. And found myself here. With you. You gave me something back when I needed it most. A second chance.
I did?
But now I have to go back to sleep again.
Are you sad?
Would you mind if I stayed here with you?
Sure, if it'll make you feel better.
Thank you.
And they have no idea what lies ahead of them. Three stars. In time, the worlds would be saved by these two heroes who stood beneath the same blaze of stars. Final battle report, game mode critical, 88% completion. I use Sonic Blade the most, really? Why? Oh, the tournaments. It took me 82 hours to complete all of this? I don't know where it's pulling that from. I don't know which files it's pulling it from. But, if we go into the save menu, after saving, be sure to hang on to this clear data. You may find use for it down the line. And congratulations, you have unlocked the secret episode. To play, first you need to create special save file, save data. So I will do that. And to begin the secret episode, choose continue and load that save data. So I will most likely do that in the next episode. For now, I hope you've been enjoying this. And please join me again for another episode of Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep.